Hello everyone and welcome back to SDGun and Winner's History and welcome to map 12 North Pole. Enemy advances to occupy space. So, here we are again. The previous map I actually fulfilled that using the wrong objective, so Jesus, damn, there's a lot of these guys here. The G-Diver, aquatic unit, of course. I should have killed everyone, but instead I went the very right, but I fixed that. I also took the opportunity to boost my units a little bit. I now have 5 of the highest tier battleships. 2 of my burgers are, actually 3 of my burgers are on maximum level. One of them has 1 promotion, so I still need to work on that guy a little bit. My shiny Gundam has maximum promotion. I still have those 2 useless guys just kind of hanging around here. So, where are you? You're here. Get you aboard this guy here. You can move. No, damn. You can move far on this map here. So you can move north. Yeah, you can take care of those guys. That shouldn't be too much of a challenge. Then we're going to need some firepower here, and their main base is over here. So let's get some burgers in here. You can just board some random ships here. Do I even need? I guess you can move on foot. That should be good enough. Provide you can even can could you even? Oh, you can actually reach that. That's good to know. But you could reach this guy here. That's good too. Oh damn, 50 hit points. Jeez. Yeah, this is a this guy here. He's, I guess you can see he's a little bit slow, but that's a it's an aquatic unit. Oh damn, that guy's taking damage like crazy. Another thing I discovered is that the damage of the green burger guys doesn't seem to scale linearly for both their melee and their range attacks. So generally for a lot of units, at least the lower level, the laser is actually stronger than the lightsaber, but it's more difficult to hit stuff with it in my opinion. So you can, I don't know, get over here, so attack their main base. So I still like to use the saber, even though the laser would do more damage. But I found out that the burgers guy, a laser initially does more damage, but then the saber gets a lot stronger. The same goes for the shiny gun. The shiny gun's laser does 10 points of damage to some units, which is insane. And it's not true for lower levels. So the burgers melee weapon damage output increases faster than the laser's output, at least for some units. Because, and same goes for the shiny gun. Some units only take a single point of damage from the shining Gundam's laser, so keep that in mind. So let's see what these guys here are. Oh, occupying, of course. Understandable. So yeah, the North Pole map here has quite a bit of water. It's not, again, difficult terrain is usually to my advantage, not to the enemy's advantage. Oh, yeah, and you challenged that guy. That's only, oh, maybe that isn't going to get you. Oh, it's Zeppelin guy. Maybe that isn't going to get you killed because, oh, or maybe it is. I still need a fair amount of hits here, so yeah, just need 8 hits. Yeah, it's not going to happen. But yeah, I hoped I could kill that guy so I could occupy that factory, but oh, yeah, well, still almost died. But it's okay, I've got enough guys loaded up here for that to happen during the next round. So yeah, and the North Pole has a ton of cities in the future. Ooh, 70 hit points. Jeez, I have to watch out for those guys here. Oh, well, still only deals a single point of damage. Barely takes any damage though, so, but... Well, no, that's not really true. I guess he just got lucky in the beginning. Yeah, I thought of this guy here was scary, but I guess it's just an unpromoted unit. That's always better, yes. The promoted strong ones, those are the scary ones. Yeah, this is not a problem. I can kill both of these with just one battleship, and I've got several battleships. Yeah, I've got 5 of these big guys now. I'm pretty sure the game still expects you to not have that many. They probably want to have you like 4 or so then in total, and then have mobile units for the rest of your team. But there's no real reason to have to do that, and I've got 5 good mobile weapons, and those are sufficient to occupy stuff. Oh, it's Blue Mosquito Man. See how strong you are. Why do you, when did you lose hit, whatever, doesn't really matter. And dead. Don't let that guy escape when you don't have to. So, anything else? Oh yeah, more of these guys. But occupation always has priority in the AI script, so... Yeah, but we can clean up quite nicely here. Obviously because our units are, well, not really overpowered, but they're pretty competitive. And these diver guys, yeah, they're very slow. Which doesn't really make them worse at dodging, as it seems. They still seem to dodge fairly well, but that primarily seems to be the case because the AI's dodging patterns just seems to be random. Obviously a human should always keep to the very right or left, depending on which part of the screen you're on, so you can see those lasers coming, at least occasionally, not eventually. So we've got two battleships there, I should probably check those out. And one of these, but the Salamis one, unpromoted, isn't very scary. So, oh, Batman, yeah, that's okay. How many units do I have anyway? I have 14. And yeah, they've got 15 because I smoked a bunch. These ones are both double promoted, but that's manageable for my... Ah, you just killed this guy here. That's manageable for my... battleships. If only by sheer numbers. So, how do we handle this? You're almost dead. You are not scratched at all. So there's one guy. I can use that guy for... You know what? You can kill this guy here. Can occupy that factory, then I can get another cheap unit I don't want, but that's okay. And there we go. You're done, and I can occupy... That was my pink guy, and you have... Oh yeah, you've got Burger Guy aboard. So you can take care of that guy. And I like how many custom backgrounds have. I mean, you'd think they just choose a sky background, but I don't think there's any other ice map, so they designed this just for the specific map here, which is kind of nice. There we go. And you could... Oh yeah, you know what, you may as well kill that guy while we're at it. Ooh, that's a... Is it a double promoted psycho? I think it is. Damn, that was a mistake. I'm going to survive this, but that guy's going to deal some damage. Yeah, ooh, damn. Should really pay attention to what I'm actually facing here. Yeah, I have to get Burger Guy in there. And yeah, this is... Ooh, hoo hoo. You have to watch out for that guy. Just check these guys, 75. That one guy's fairly strong, but manageable. These guys here are alright. Not strong enough to be an issue for my battleships. You've got one guy aboard. Oh, I could actually just move up here with you guys. And... But then again, I should probably just... Do you know what? I should probably just clear out these guys here. It's easier. Keep my backyard clean. And... Yeah, there we go. That should not be a problem either. There we go. How strong are these guys? Mostly dead, but not quite dead. Anyone aboard here? Nope, doesn't look like it, but that's okay. But you can leave and kill this guy here. There we go. And I don't know, I guess it doesn't really matter which one of these you kill. Is there? No, none of you is on the city, so just didn't even have to move there. I could have just used bombardment, but whatever. Yeah, just kill this one here. And there we go. Then let's see. I probably wouldn't have to put these guys here through the middle. Actually, you can occupy this because you're fully promoted anyway, so no need to. Oh, and you. I suppose you can occupy this. Didn't even remember I had you aboard there. But I'm okay with that, obviously. And you can engage those battleships. And you can just tack along, I suppose. There we go. And I think that's it for me. Yeah, it is. So let's see what they do now. Okay, those guys move south. Understandable. But that's okay. I think that guy has 75 hit points. Fairly strong, but I've got multiple battleships there, so it still shouldn't be much of a problem. Even though I think that, yeah, that guy's going to survive, but that's okay. He did only about 20 points of damage, which is not too scary, and he lost 60 hit points. That is actually quite a lot. Okay, that guy's going to come after me as well, but that's okay too. Yeah. Yeah, none of these guys is too scary. Not that I have these high-level battleships. I've had the first tier ones. They'd probably die after two of these encounters. But yeah, they seem to be an odd spot in between. They can only face weaker mobile weapons and their own, because they fail against both promoted mobile weapons and other battleships. Whereas my unpromoted high-tier battleships, they're still good enough to face promoted units. Yeah, you face this one here, then I can kill you with my space burger next time. But yeah, should pay attention to this guy here, because this guy here is strong. But not strong enough, so he's about down to 1/3 of his hit points. Slightly less, so that's good enough for me. And oh yeah, you're going to attack that guy, naturally. That might even get me a promotion if it continues like that. So, here we go, and there we go. And that's it for Red. Yeah, look at this concentration of battleships. It's getting a bit ridiculous, to be honest. So, you're still here, 27 hit points. Oh yeah, I can easily take you. No problem whatsoever. Pink Space Samurai. But damn, this guy doesn't take a whole lot of damage from my melee attack, but it's okay. It's still enough. Yep, and that did get me a promotion, I think. Oh yeah, I forgot, now I've got one of these guys here. I'll just waste you against one of these guys here. I can't be bothered to drag even more of these guys here around. Okay, you occupy that during the next round, as it seems. You get over here. You can just move into this general direction here. And yeah, you're damaged. You can... Oh, you are twice promoted already? Wow. Not bad. And this one here got one promotion. It's nice as well. So how strong are you? You know what? You may as well finish this guy here off. And yeah, then let's concentrate on those battleships. There we go. Everyone's dead. And you? Oh, wow! A lot of these guys already got promotions. I didn't recall that being the case, but that's okay. Obviously, it's okay because it's great. These guys here have double promotions, but they still don't deal a whole lot of damage against me. At least not right now. So let's actually check our units. Yeah, all but one of my guys are already promoted. That's not bad at all. Yeah, my space burgers are almost all maxed out. Now this is going very well, especially considering how high tier my guys are and how long they need to be promoted. Then again, the enemy tends to gang up on... So what could you do? You could actually leave here. You can occupy some stuff there. Oh, you can go ahead after me as well. They always like to do that, don't they? So the enemy actually wins this map by reaching the top. So I should probably, at least not, well, don't have to completely lock them in, but put some units there so that they can't do it in one round. They can't do it in one turn, then I can just completely block them with my ships if need be. Oh yeah, bombardment, of course. It's okay. The Shining Gundam can take it. The Shining Gundam looks so cute. It's kind of like chubby and cheerful. Oh, looks like this one here is ready. I'm okay with that. I'll blow you up with the other guy. There we go. So it's time to gang up on you. There we go. And then let's just move the other ship in there as well. Then we should be good. Yeah, this guy can't escape now. He could fly around me, but it's unlikely to happen. Even if it does, he can just block its path again, so not much of an issue. Then let's gang up on you as well. Yeah, this is the reason why you want these battleships. If you only have weaker battleships and they're not promoted, these guys can actually mess you up if you don't watch out. So you have... Oh, no, you are... You're not suitable to participate in this fight here. Let's block your path as well. And this is going to take a while, but it's going to be okay. Yeah, we can occupy everything they have, but the problem is we need to blow up these guys for that anyway, because both of them are protecting spaceports, so... Duh. I suppose... You could... kill this guy here, if need be. Wow, you are more damaged than I thought you'd be, but this guy has no promotion whatsoever, so not a problem still. Should keep an eye on you, though. So there's... Oh. Where the hell did that guy come from? Seriously, where... I didn't even remember having one of those. Well, whatever. I guess you're here now. Or did I... I did have to... Yeah, that's the third... Like, oh, yeah, I want to waste this guy here. Forgot about that. Yeah, I'll do that soon. Oh yeah, just produce that guy. You know what, you may as well occupy some cities here, since we're at it. And Spaceburger, you get to occupy that city during the next round. And I think we're mostly done here now. Yep, that should be it. And looks like this guy is going to take care for that. Take care of that for me. Well, almost. A long-range bombardment doesn't really deal all that much damage. And you can't fire back, but that's okay. Another one of these. Don't know why you... Oh, you're engaging my shiny gun. Well, we can have that. Let's kill the goddamn Batman. There we go. Yeah, 10 points of damage with just one lightsaber swing. That is pretty vicious. So there we go. You can occupy this and engage this guy here. So you can get yourself killed. Boom, boom, and boom. There we go. That should solve that problem. I mean, I could have fired at that guy just to kill him a little bit faster, but, well, whatever. So, you occupy this place, and how strong are these guys still? Still have a decent amount of hit points left, but it's not going to last forever, let's put it that way. There we go. And you know what, you can join this fight here, just to speed it up. And then we can probably finish it off in two turns, yeah. Together with that other guy we should. And then you can all gang up on that other guy. But he's in the corner, so... Actually, I can gang up on that guy because we have long-range bombardment. I forgot about that. There we go. Getting there, slowly but surely. Can you actually reach that? Yeah, you can. So let's just do it like this. May as well finish off that one guy a little bit faster. Yeah, one more bombardment and he's down. Can I reach him with the other guy? I don't think I can. Like, wait. Or I just about can. Oh, but that guy can't shoot back, so... Well. Goodbye and see you later. Okay, solve that problem. And... You try to kill this guy here. Yeah, that guy has more hit points than you, but that should change rather soon. Well, sort of, but not as much as I would like it to. So did anyone get a promotion out of this? Probably. I'm not quite sure, but it doesn't really matter all that much. It's not like I can change it now anyway. Oh. Yeah, I should be careful here. Oh, it's this guy here. This guy actually looks pretty sweet. Looks very 90s. Oh, actually, you know what? No, he actually looks a little bit more 80s, but that's just me. He's probably 70s. Provided he's from the first Mobile Suit Gundam season, or series rather. Which, I mean, I know it originally aired in 1979, but did it air just over a year? He might have aired into the 90s, who knows. It's not really that important, so is it? Sure, I can reach this guy here, but he can't reach me. What a shame. So there we go. And let's do this again. Yeah, none of these guys is fully promoted, so no need to split experience here. I think I can kill this guy too, or can I? Yeah, probably can. There we go. Oh, and he can actually shoot back for now. For once. And yeah, I can definitely kill that guy. So who should get the kill? Let's try to get it with you, so you get your promotion. And there we go. Boom. Okay, that's sad. Now it's only you who's left. Yeah, you can finish that. Or if not, my Shining Gundam can take that guy. Yep, this is over now. And there we go. Map clear. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care and goodbye.